kuhusu ibada, ibada ni nini? Na tukasema vitu ambazo sio ibada, siko na watu wako na watu wanakumbuka tukisema nini jana. Kwa hiyo tunakumbuka jana tukisema nini about ibada sio nini. Tukasema tutachukua tukisema nini. Sasa mimi tutakuwa na mzima swali sasa. Kwa hiyo wana mzima swali. Amen. Aleluya. Aleluya. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. Nitafunza polepole sana mpaka tuongee, tusipomaliza ni sawa sawa, ndio wakati mwingine tumalize. Amen. Bwana asifiwe sana. Kwa hiyo jana tukasema what worship is not, na tukasema kwa tuongee mambo mengi sana, tuweka foundation kama Ukristiani zaidi. Tukasema kwamba what worship is not, tukasema sio aina ya huduma, it's not a type of service. Na tukasema kwamba namba 2 sio music genre, ama sio aina fulani ya muziki ama nyimbo. Na namba 3 tukasema kwamba sio kuimba nyimbo, you know, kuimba nyimbo tu. Na baada tukasema kwamba sio kitu ambacho kinafocus sisi wanadamu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Number 1 is not a type of service. Number 2 is not a music genre. Number 3 is singing, is not singing hymns and songs. And number 4, it is not a human focused activity. Umepata hizo vitu nne vile? Bwana asifiwe sana. Bwana asifiwe. Na mkiendea kwa Bwana mnaiona mtawatoa hivi na mtabakia na soko peke yake. Ama na mnaleta. Ama mimi kuja hapa mhubiri wa Mungu na mimi nikae chini. Bwana asifiwe sana. Praise the Lord. Mungu na gani hivi si vyati. Praise the Lord. Ambaye afikia kwenye wakati kati utakuja kuhubiri hapa mbele. Na msao sana je mbele. Utakupea. I'll give you a lot of money. You can't preach. Somebody shout amen. Amen. So, we talked about a few things from there. Kitu kingine ambacho tunafaa kujua. You know, na ni vizuri kwa sababu yale maneno nikaongea kwa maneno fulani ya Kiebrania ni mazuri, kwa sababu kama tutasoma Biblia in the light of, you know, in the Hebrew and also Greek, we will not be able to understand the scriptures correctly. Tutakuwa tunasema kitu kwa maana ya hivi, lakini maandishi hivyo, kwa sababu Biblia imeandikwa ina, you know, ina kati ya sasa. Ni sawa sawa jamani? Ni sawa sawa. Kwa sababu Biblia imeandikwa ina kati ya sasa, kwa sababu tuelewe hiyo kati iko hapo ni nini. Tusipojua the culture that, you know, is in the Bible, we're not able to define words right, to define maneno to communicate vizuri. Tukasema kidogo kidogo kwamba katika Old Testament ile neno linatoka kuonyesha ibada ni neno shaka, na pia kuna neno lingine ambalo linatumwa sharat, inaitwa sharat pia. Leo kwa nini tunaomba hivi? Namba 1, shaka ni kupiga magoti. Tunaweza kusema kwa kuelewa. Kupiga magoti ni kama kupiga magoti. Na sharat nayo, ile neno ambalo tumetumwa sharat nayo ni sabas, seven sabas, sabas, sabas. Kwa hiyo kama tunataka kuelewa vizuri, tukuje katika New Testament, maana mawili pia yametumiwa ya Kigiriki, na moja hiyo neno ni proskinio, which means inasema pia kupiga magoti. Kwa hivyo kama ni proskinio katika New Testament, shaka katika Old Testament, sharat katika Old Testament alikuwa anamaanisha sabas, vile maisha unaishi. Na New Testament inasema that shego, hiyo nami inatumika pale kumaanisha service pia. Ni sawa sawa jamani? Kwa hivyo ibada iko namna mbili. Kuna hiyo kupiga magoti, kuna kupiga magoti na shake 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 shake, tuna shake na tunalia. Lakini kuna hiyo pia ibada hiyo nyingine ambayo hata kama usheni bado kuna. Ni sawa sawa jamani? Service ambapo kuanzia Monday mpaka Wednesday wewe mwenyewe pia unaabudu. From Monday to Wednesday to Sunday, from Monday to Sunday you are still worshiping God. Let's talk something this person. You are still worshiping God. Unaabudu Bwana kuanzia Monday mpaka Sunday. Mpaka Sunday. Watu wengine wanafikiri pale unakuta kushake, una shake, una lio hapa kanisani, lakini ukienda pale hivi fake kulia. You know, hapo ukienda pale hivi sasa ibada imeisha, sasa wewe ukilia. Ukienda hivi ibada imeisha. Hapana, ibada imeisha. Na nataka leo nikueleze vizuri, na nitakueleza Mungu wangu sahihi. Nitakupeleka pole pole mpaka uelewe. Tunaongea just say the lesson all about it. Let me just say now, I'm talking about the foundation. Let me just say this, you know, that I'm talking about the yourself from destiny worship. Say the foundation of worship. Let's see where this thing is coming from. Let's see where it's coming from. What is the mind of God concerning worship? The meaning of what of what carry on move. Worship was still there, and worship will still be there. Amen. I said yesterday that all Christian sacraments, all Christian sacraments we observe, should lead us to worship. Everything. Keep from touch from finding katika maisha ya Kristo. Chote kinafaa kutuongoza katika imani. Kutoa tunatoa, tunachukua watu wasio kuabudu. Kuomba tunaomba, tunachukua watu wasio kuabudu. Hii Bible ni kwamba tunachukua watu wasio kuabudu. I want to say something. Some say that mission is not the goal of the church. Evangelism mission, it is not the goal of the church. It is not. The goal of Christianity and church generally is to worship God. You know why? Because missions exist because worship is not there. We do evangelism because worship is not there. You know what is it doing? The end of Christianity is worship. How is something? To not have put a word of movement, not put a way. Are you getting it? The end of Christianity is worship. The goal of Christianity is not just mission. You get something? Not mission. No. The Great Commission is not going in, it's not the going, like we are saying. No. The Great Commission is to make disciples. It is someone who is walking in the light, who is walking in the character of Christ. And that is indeed a mission. Are you understanding it? The goal of Christianity is worship. The mission is not, we don't just, go back to the day of the day. To be where evangelism. Evangelism is there because worship is not there. Because worship answers this one fundamental question for how we can be in the right relationship with God. It's as simple as that. Ibada inajibu swali moja tu. Vile tunaweza kuwa na usalimwema na Yesu Kristo. Tumeona nini? Kwa hiyo ile ibada sisi tunafanya ni utafute wako. Ibada tunafanya ni utafute wako. Tunabatizwa tutafute wako. Tunafanya ndio tuende kwenye goal ya worship. Bwana Yesu asante. Worship is the highest human vocation. Worship is central to Christ. Worship is central. Let me say this. Worship is central to you as a creature. Hata ndio tena. Worship is central to you as a creature. Very, very simple. It is the highest human vocation. Hicho ndicho kitu cha maana zaidi ambacho mwanadamu aliumbwa kufanya. Tunaona jambo. Are we together there? You are never so right as a human being from when you worship God. I want to say that again. You are never so right as a human being. You are never so normal like a human being like when you worship God. If you don't worship God, you are not normal. You are not okay. No, you are not alright. Because it is near to Papa. Wanadamu wameumbwa kwa Mungu. Ile siku utapata wabudu basi wewe wanadamu wako kuna shetani. Am I talking something this way? Are we getting something? Unapata jamani? It is the highest human vocation. Worship is not an activity of selected few. No, it is something what you call an inexorable act of anyone called human. In other words, ibada sio ya watu wachache ambao wametanguliwa. Ni kitu ambacho wanadamu, kama unaitwa mwanadamu, uweze kuyafanya. You must worship. And by the way, if you don't worship God, you worship something else. Kama utaabudu Mungu, utaabudu kitu kingine. Because tumeumbwa na mwanadamu. Kama utaabudu Mungu, tutaabudu pesa. Kama sio, we will worship something. If we don't worship God, are we getting something here? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are never so right As you are being listed when we worship, we will never, never summon as you are being listed when we worship. Wakati na kuto utakuwa sasa no more human beings. Wakati na sifu utakuwa no more human beings. Bwana sifu sana. Praise the Lord. Are you getting something here? Tunapatana. 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 Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It is so weird. The dead is not going to be bad. So we are not going to find it. But hand. Sio nyimbo ambazo tunaimba, sio maombi ambayo tunaomba, sio kutoka tunatoa. Na nikasema jana kuna concept nimesikia watu wengi wakihubiri, wanasema ambao wahubiri wanasema oh hakuna shida, hata kama wewe ino principle kutoa kutoa iko na principle, you just give and get blessed. No, it is not true. It is not true at all. If you don't walk with God, even if you give, you are giving as for a problem. And even if you prosper, you won't prosper in the right way. Out of prosper, you are not prospering, but in the right way. Out of you make profit, profit happens is outside the key, it is there. Anything can happen. Anything can happen to your profit. Hallelujah. What is this? Why do you say my woman, in the Old Testament, we hate priesthood. In the New Testament, we are the priesthood. And God will come. Tulikuwanga na makuhani anakujibu sisi ndio makuhani. Nikasema kwamba katika new covenant, in the old covenant, it is a substantial thing like an offering which qualifies a man. You had to give to qualify it. But the new covenant, it is us who qualify a substantial thing. Pesa yangu haimaanishi kitu kwa kama mwili wangu uliotapewa kwa Mungu. Bwana msiwe. One of the greatest worship leaders in the New Testament called Paul is saying, I beseech you therefore, brethren, Romans 12, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, because this is your true act of worship. Beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your what? Living sacrifice, something authentic, original, not like a living sacrifice, no, a living sacrifice, because what I want is something original, something authentic, a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable what? Service. That's what again comes, and what I train again comes then, you know, service, it's your reasonable service, it's your two act of worship. Your mind doesn't want to see my name as a bad man. It was very important that you be number one. You get something? To come on, gentlemen, it's your true act of worship. It is your reasonable service. Kila mwacho kunafanya leo, kufanya mwili yetu, mwili yetu, kila mwacho kunafanya, kinafaa kwa ibada kwa Mungu. Kwa hivyo kutoa kwetu, lazima kwa namna ya maisha mbaya, you know, maisha mbaya ni mema mbele ya Mungu. Matendo mema mbele ya Mungu. Wewe usisema kwamba unatoa alafu uko qualified mbele ya Mungu. Worship is one transaction. One transaction. Say one transaction. Ni transaction moja. Kama utaanza kujua worship is different types of worship, unaanza kusema, if when I'm teaching about worship, I never tell people to teach to say different types of worship. No. It is just one transaction, which begins from the God. My life is given to God. Giving an effort is a one transaction. It's not two types of worship. For some people, they say, "Oh, kuna aina mbili ama tatu za ibada." Wengine wanasema kwamba kuna kutoa, kuna kuimba, kuna kufanya hivi. Kwa hivyo mtu akiimba anasema, "Basi kama nimeimba mimi nimesha." Wale wengine wakufa sana tu. Hiyo ipo ndio ibada yao. Hapana. Ibadah transaction moja, it is one transaction which begins from the life of an individual to everything else that he gives God. God bless. Are you getting something here? It's not two things, it's not two types, no, one person which must begin from you. And beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God to present your body.
kutoa. Ibada yako ya kwanza sio kwanza kuimba, hapana. Ibada yako ya kwanza ndio hii, mwili ambao kwanza unapenda. Ha! Na nikasema kwamba ibada sio kile ambacho tunafanya. Worship is not what you do. Worship is who we are. Worship is our identity. Isuria. Isuria. Hallelujah. I have had so many times in Nairobi and they say that, oh, when you talk about wanasema kwamba oh, mwili wa Mungu, I don't want mwili sio wa wokovu. I don't want Mungu anataka sio nini. Hata mimi nimesikia a lot of theories about worship. Mungu anataka tu sio nini, anataka roho. Mungu anataka sio nini, anataka roho. I don't know, sielewi kuna roho sio mwili. But the Bible says something holy and acceptable before the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The body is a manifestation of worship. Hata ukasema kwamba the body does not get saved. The body is just a manifestation of what is inside. This body, I'm doing like this because something inside has already done that. This thing cannot work at all. Because I'm saying, when you don't have that for yet, and you don't have that for yet, you don't have that for yet, you don't have that for yet, you don't have that for yet. And then you don't get that. You don't have that for yet. It's just an expression of what is inside of me. The soul and the soul. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Woo! I tell you what people keep on. What people keep on doing. Intent is the move of God. Move on to the spirit. We need to say that we have a foundation. And now we have something that we have planned. We have planned to be a level. Chapter 28. That's what the book of Ezekiel 28 reads from verse. Let's project Ezekiel 28. And verse from verse 12 there. Verse 12. Ezekiel 28. 28. Ezekiel 28. Verse 12. Verse 12. It says, someone take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyrus and say unto him, thus said the Lord God, thou seest of the sun, you know, full of wisdom and perfect in what? In beauty. Of course, we're talking about Lucifer. Let's go past that 23. I mean, past 13. We're talking about Lucifer here. By the way, the word Lucifer, I don't mean that in the other gentleman. I'm confused about what is that problem. Because Lucifer, he's put a title in the other. The word Lucifer, the only time they have used the word Lucifer in the Bible is only once. In the book of Isaiah 14, I think verse 12, 13. That was the only time they have used the word Lucifer. Can you go there, Isaiah 14, before you come to this place? Isaiah 14, you know? Yeah. How have God fallen from what? Heaven or what? I'm sure it's not coming, let's go. From where? Heaven. Or what? Son of the Lord. How about cut out the ground which deeds wicked in the nations? The only time they have used, I'm teaching here, is related. The only time they have used the word Lucifer, it is this time in the Bible. There is not any other time they have used the word Lucifer. Not any other time. I will tell you why they have not used the word Lucifer again. I want to do here. But hakuna mahali pengine Lucifer ametumika. Hiyo ni Lucifer. Ndio kwa sababu. Na mbona is the son of God? Is son of God. Is one of the children. Ni mmoja wa wale malaika wa kuleta nini? Waku. Malaika ni waku. You know, some of those archangels. Of course, Michael Gabriel, Lucifer was one of them. Lucifer, who definitely I know you've had stories from the Sunday school that was a child in worship music and all that. You play a bunch of words. You must just scare you. You must just come to a Sunday school. Please come and get a Sunday school. Please, you get go back to Sunday school. So many of you just said, let you all be there. So you must just come to Sunday school. Lucifer. Now, what is Lucifer? By itself, Lucifer, tell you what Lucifer means and what they're called. Lucifer, originally, is from a Hebrew word called Eileh. Apparently, this is the word Lucifer. From a part of the name Eileh, and after a part of the name Allah, which means to shine, to be clear. That's what we call the morning star. You know what I'm saying? Son of God, at the moment.
Allah. For praise and worship to shine, to be blessed, to be spirit. Then for the word Allah, we get the word Hallelujah. Take a deep breath. The root word, the Lucifer. Kutoka Lucifer, the Kunya Hele. Kutoka Hele, tunapata Allah. Na kutoka Allah, tunapata Hallelujah. Mungu wangu. Tema kufuza niyo kuhisi ya Hele. In other words, what it means that Lucifer never needed to say the Hallelujah. He was actually the Hallelujah. Because Lucifer, that's the original word, up to Hallelujah. Lucifer was simply mean Hallelujah. I know you have never told that anyway. But listen very well. In a manner of saying, what they're doing. The Omar and the Katika, the book of Revelation, when they are talking about the fallen nature of Satan, Lucifer, they never even want Lucifer. They say Satan. They call it Satan. They call it the old Satan. But they never use Lucifer. Look at what they're doing. Why Satan here in the temple? Up to me, in the temple. Lucifer, up. Because Lucifer was a very good one at that time. It was an angel of the covenant. It was a good name, meaning Hallelujah. Na Mungu alikuwa ameshamba Lucifer. Sio tu kufanya Hallelujah na kusema Hallelujah, lakini kukua Hallelujah. Yeye mwenyewe. The intention of God is that Lucifer must not say it, he must be it. God. Wewe unapata dhambi mweleza wale wengine. What is this? Intention of God kwamba shetani. Not that Satan, Lucifer. Lucifer was supposed to be the Hallelujah. And was. Wakati alisimama mbele ya Mungu alikuwa msafi. Kusimama peke yake. Kusimama peke yake. Tu kusema. Kusimama. Kusimama. Standing before God was enough. Mushrikine. Kusimama mbele ya Mungu alikuwa enough. It was enough. Because he never needed to say it. He was it. How did he try to sell them? He ain't going to go hard on Genesis chapter 1:1-2. The story of creation. Tunapata kwamba kuna accounts of creation. Na pale katika accounts of creation, tunaona Lucifer coming in the fallen nature of the garden of Eden. You can ask when. And I put a gamma, you know, like a fallen, you know, something, right? It was a serpent. He came like a serpent now. He was very fallen. And the question that you must ask yourself is that when did this man fall? That even in Genesis, a council of creation, and I put a fallen in it, and I look up with them there. But then we say that the other was there. That it was happening, a council, what happened was for high school, serpent, a CRE, when I do a council of creation. I mean, you know, you know, you know, when I'm quite a young person, I'm saying, by the way, Papa, I read Genesis chapter 1, and I put it in the fallen nature, and I sang it out. What did I lose with that? I'm going to go back to Ezekiel 28. Don't lose that word to Lucifer, by the way. So I've said that they cannot use that word again. I want you to be a friend and then Lucifer must stop Lucifer by Lucifer. It is meant an end to that cover. An end to that cover. It was a woman. And that's when he fell, 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 when he suffered. Like you know, because you want to sue your head. Yes, somebody come up in there, come up in there, and say, Kill the one, you're probably here, but I don't know what it is. Look at it. When I say, what was about? When I say, what was about, square? Now, when I'm not about, I said, square? That's exactly what you can have the name, but you fail. Hallelujah. Look at this one now. Verse 13. Let's go to verse 13. He's the prophet in beauty. Thou hast, look at this. This one refers to Lucifer. Thou hast been when? Look at this one. When Messiah what it did, the captain of what?
God. God will be God.
You have been there that every precious stone was uncovered. The sadness, the topaz, and the diamond, the pain, the onyx, and the just for the sapphire, the emerald, and the capital gold. He was there. So this will be the picture of, you know, Abel, of course, who tested the garden of Eden. The garden of God. You have been there in that same garden. The same garden that Adam and Peter were. Lucifer was already there before Adam.
nirudio kita
asapo thou hast been in Eden.
Where we shall go in Eden, the God of God. A catch.
And then when he falls, then he falls. Lucifer was yes, he was there in the perfect pit. He was perfect. It was okay. The Bible says the one mission of a team was to be the path was prepared in thee. In the dark now, what God then we won't go you are perfect in Eden. Accounts of Christian Genesis chapter 1, we see him in the flesh. Like if now I want to swallow it without Julissa and it opened up there. When was Lucifer in the Garden of Eden? And why would God want to even put him in the first place? What did he mean? He wasn't going to work together with him. I'm going to find him. And after the fall of Satan, we see which looks like immediately man is placed in the same garden. Satan will come to you and look at him. But he will not come to let's go back. Let's go to that. Look at this one. Look at this. Tapios and emerald and gold. The Bible says the workmanship. Look at that one. The workmanship of your timbers and of your pipes was prepared for you. Please give me the word King James. Look at this one. And the yes. And what was it of your Jesus was prepared in thee. And of course, it's the reading translation. In the day that thou was created, they were prepared in him. Different is any big instrument. They were prepared in him. Let me tell you something. And the Bible said the pipe. The wind instrument, the saxophone, also the keyboard lies also in the wind instrument, all these things. They are level of them. The keyboards, the saxophone, the brass, I mean all those things. It's a sort of, they like that. The Bible says all these things were prepared inside them. In the day it was created. That's why I say Lucifer, it does not totally mean in a manner. Lucifer means also you realize it has got this connection with the word that I read. He never needed to say it. He was it. And he can say, was enough. Let's go to Julius' swami here. Wakati sisi nasimama mbele ya Mungu ni enough as well as enough. Lazima tukwambie Mungu anaromeki sana. Mungu alikwambia nakupenda, anakwambia nakupenda, nikasema hivi, nikasema hivi, nikasema. That's our standing already become. That's our standing before God satisfied even before we say anything. Kusimama kwetu mbele ya Mungu kuna satisfy Mungu au we need to add a lot of words to even show God that you see what God is trying to do? And then the Bible says the workmanship. The one workmanship. Look at this one. The workmanship of your temperance. The one workmanship in Hebrew. The workmanship of your talent. Workmanship. Workmanship. Workmanship means the work of an actor. Kazi. I'm a kazi ya usani. Kazi ya nini? Ya usani. It means job. It means what? Say job. It means job. It also means what one is called to do for life. In a manisha, in other words, it means occupation. It means what? When a man is saying that a lot of the girls are going to ask you then, wrong name, Sunday, that's not occupation. Which I just have to come with. Yeah? When I say, I'm a teacher, I'm a zero word, I'm a banker, I'm a word, which I just have to come with. The workmanship, you remember the manuscript. It means what one is sent to do for life. Here, keep it on the floor, finding a challenge. Guilty. The workmanship of your talent, your job, your occupation was prepared in thee in the day that thou was created. Let's go continue verse 14. And then verse 14. Thou art the anointed cherub that covered. Lucifer, you are so anointed. Anointed. And by that word anointed, we are what I do. You are so the anointed one. the word they're using, anointed, the Greek servant, is not even this one. This one is so different. This one in Hebrew means Mimshak, which means anointing or extension. It can be something like extended. Anyway, the way to understand, that's what it means. And what I'm about, in fact, I say, Lucifer, the one of them. So beautiful, so wonderful. His wings were so bigger than those ones of Gabriel. Hallelujah. And I have said it, that cover, the word cover in Hebrew means what? It means Shonanish, several Shonanish. It means to intertwine. It was intertwined and put a Messiah Shonanish. In other words, Lucifer had put a Messiah Shonanish covered with them because his work was to cover the throne. In other words, it's like he had already been intertwined with the throne of God. And he put a cover of Shonanish for that in him. He has a religious side of him and he has a cultural side of him, Lord. Because the workmanship means the occupation. The workmanship of your children. You can see that you can see that. That's the cultural side of you. Two of us. You are working. That's the cultural. That's the first one you could refer to as cultural side of you. Lucifer had the cultural side of it, and that was making music. The workmanship of the timbers was playing. But also, he had another third dimension, a religious dimension of covering the act. And one dimension, he had a body of Nika Nika. The throne of God. Now, you look at Nika. Inasemekana ni kama alikuwa ameshonanishwa naye. Nataka kuuliza swali. Kama kuna kazi ya kufanya, si kazi ya kuimba jamani, na hiyo wimbo yake. Na ameniambia kwamba yeye ameshonanishwa na nini? Ameshonanishwa na nini? Wacha tufikirie vizuri. Nafro. Sasa kuuliza swali. Let's think like human beings. Kama alikuwa anataka kufanya kazi, unafikiri angeacha throne? Alafu baada ya kufanya kazi. Talk to me.
Kwa sababu ukikula hiyo matunda pia this in a catcher's sight of yourself, you will have sin before me. In other words, even your catcher's sight, what you think is your catcher's sight, is also sin if you don't do it right. And I want to say this one, tell you something. The first sin to be committed was not a religious mistake. The first mistake to be committed was not a religious mistake. It was a catcher mistake. Can I say again? Some people tell them, even though he can see some Mungu side, see, it was not a religious mistake. It was a catcher mistake. Nilikwambia usikule na unakula. Sio kwa sababu Adamu hakupatikana in the time, atia kwa sababu alipatia asiuni. It's not because he never gave time. It's because he never tried in the school where he was employed. It's because he never worked right in the bank. God was so mad. The mistake was cultural, not even religious. Then from there we come to the time of Adam, you know, come to the time of I have acquired a man from the Lord. You know what happened? The sacrifices. Mungu anataka kurectify kitu, anasema kutoka Lucifer. Kuna kitu anataka, kuna kitu lakini sasa huyu Adam amekosa, sijui nifanye nini. And then he sees, we come in. Maybe from Apple I can raise it again. And Apple is there. Apple, the name itself means vanity, it means nothing. It means nothing. And that is a right attitude for worship. You can't ask for it. And he's saying, of course, this one is about you to stand, you know, in the place of who? Of how? Seth gets a son, and what does he call him? Because Enosh. Because who? Because he wants Enosh. And the Bible says, from that time, men began to call on the name of God. You see? Enosh means humanity in their weakness, humanity in their frailty, the right attitude for worship. Mungu akasema, things don't go very well. By the time we get to Genesis chapter 5, chapter 6, oh my God, the time of Noah, after chapter 8, there's some who was you happy. People are like, what? It's maybe through Noah I'm going to restore this thing. Things don't go very okay. Chapter 11, the Tower of Babel. Until the last, no verses of chapter 11, they appears a man called Terah. And then chapter 12, they mention the name of Abraham. How is chapter 11 then? Abraham and then chapter 12, story of Abraham begins. And then from the tribe, from Abraham, the Lord maybe to Abraham. And it is true, from Abraham, the Lord raises a very powerful tribe called the tribe of what? The tribe of what? The tribe of what? The tribe of Israel. The tribe of Israel. Because he raises a very powerful, you know, people called the tribe of Israel out of Adam. Out of Abraham. Now listen very carefully. There was no cultural compromise in Israel. It was not first a religious compromise. And that's first. You come up to the man and give us part of him. There was no cultural compromise in Israel, which was not first a religious compromise. There was no religious compromise in Israel, which was not first a cultural compromise. Their culture and their religion were intertwined. Is actually in the point. What can't in the natural side, when things are not okay, the religious side is affected. When things, when in the real side things are not okay, the natural side is affected. Psalm 67 verse 5, protect me. Look at it. Psalm 65 verse 7. I'm a 67 verse 5. Let me switch. Okay, yeah, this one. 67 verse 5. Let's go. Have you heard of us? Let's go. Let the people do what? Let the people do what? Praise him. Oh God, let all the people praise him. Verse 6. Then, the Bible says, seek them.
The religious side.
last two questions. Even when you're not shaking, last two questions. What is your son? Praise the Lord. What is it doing? It's not what I can do. We are worshiping. Even from your moment to me, the time of this life, after you withdraw our pattern, from after the pattern is a way to come up this. What is your son? You better listen to me. That's what we give our example. If they are right, I will bless your bed. And I will bless your mother. If you worship him, if you serve me, I will bless your bread and I will bless your water. It means if you don't worship, our bread is not blessed. Our water is not. If they lost a battle in Israel, it's not because they never had strong army. No. It's because they are worshiping their father. There's a time they went to fight as one tribe, or they are. And they went to fight, but they could not be killed as one tribe. Why? Because somebody had eaten some things. They are worshiping their father. And they could not defeat that personal tribe. They could not win. They couldn't win. Because of the religious side. We will not be able to win culturally if our religious side is a problem. And vice versa. If our cultural side is a problem. Even our religious side is not a problem. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Move on to side D. What you want to do to a brother? A so you Edam desse mundo que é limpo, limpo na parte da frente, foi que a gente vai. Aqui para ser limpo, ser limpo, para ser limpo, para. The greater challenge of worship is how you live it. Let me tell you something. On Sunday, tu kuti kumaliza ibada, apana. Tu kumaliza hapa basi tunaanza Monday, tunaanza ibada tena. Bwana sio sana. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If I am not a man in worship, I don't qualify to even not a Sunday, even not a Wednesday worshiper. I don't qualify to become a Sunday worshiper. Come on, this me or good Wednesday. What? I don't qualify to worship on Sunday. If I'm not a secret worshiper, I don't qualify to become a public worshiper. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If I'm not a secret worshiper, I don't qualify to become a public worshiper. If I'm not a Monday worshiper, if I'm not a Wednesday worshiper, if I'm not a Thursday worshiper, I don't qualify to become a Sunday worshiper. Hallelujah. It's how we live. That was the gender of God, Lucifer, the cultural side, the religious side, sort. Is it not that? Something. It's something. May the Lord help us in Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. To our amen. Questions are deep, you know, about Cain. Cain worship. I'll talk about that. Just to show you what could be in what could be the example. What is in Cain worship, what is in Abel worship, and all that. Once you said. Wewe tuelewe mambo kama haya. Tusipo kama sisi wenyewe mashahidi ayaonyeshe ibada, basi tuko na shida. Tuko na shida. Ibada sio kile ambacho tunafanya sisi. Project for me acts chapter 1. And verse 1. Look at this chapter. Look at this verse. Very powerful verse. Let's read the verse. Let's go. The what? The former ones, two times, and I made all your fears of all the Jesus began to what? To bow, look at this, to bow what? Do and what? And teach. He began to both do and teach. Jesus Christ, I told you, is one of the powerful worship leaders, you know, in the new covenant. What? He taught is what he did. What is the son? What is the son? The doing. No, there was no difference here. He was doing what he was teaching. I believe that worship, since Kanisa Bwana, we are the people that are supposed to examine the worship into the rest of the world. You know, what we teach to the world, we must do. Give it to mafunza dunia kama kanisa la Kristo lazima tukifanye. Na by this word do, what you become of that word itself do, it is in continuous tense. When reading in Greek, in other words, it's not something you did that stopped doing. It is habitual. Something is doing every day. Ni kitu anafanya kila siku. Kila siku is a habit. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Kitu anafanya kila siku. Mungu atusaidie. Anasifiwe. Sijui mlikuwa mnataka kusikia ibada ya nini? Kuombea kuokoka kwa Mungu. Unataka hiyo? Bwana sio sana. Unataka niwaambie ibada ya kuimba? Am I teaching hard? Teaching like Jesus Christ or something like that? Let me see what you're doing. Okay, let me see what you're casting. Don't go for a car, okay? Bwana sio sana. Kwa hiyo, at least I wanted to show you the honest devotion. The practice of worship is clear. That indeed, what we refer to as cattle is worship to God. What we refer to as leaders is worship to God. Both of them are worship to God. And we need to realize that, therefore, our worship will change. Who doesn't want to do what we have to learn and give us a certain respect to God? Wakati ito nifani. Wakati unafanya chochote ibada inafanya. Worship is a possibility. Some of you are like, I don't know why I want to break this, by the way. Let me tell something. As a worship teacher, there's nothing like a mood worship. Every time is a mood worship. There's nothing like it. It's where your mood neighbor. No. Let me tell you something. The things you are coming to do are like Sunday service and the worship happenings are events. Events are tough. Anyway, they are working our spirits. But they are working our spirits to go and do exactly what we must do all our life. And that is worship. We don't come to worship God in an event. We come to get awake to continue doing it. Sunday service does not come. We don't come to worship God on Sunday. No, we come to be awake to continue worship. It is not about to say we come to worship on Sunday. No, my brothers and sisters. Worship. An event. When you mess up, worship is not an event, it's who we are, it's what we are doing from Monday to Sunday. Therefore, you mess up every event, every Christian event we are doing is just to awaken us. Because we're human beings. See, we're not going to have a time to go to the moment, we're not going to have a time to shine, but we're not going to have a time to and we continue to worship. Because worship is who we are, worship is what we do, worship is our vocation. Worship your kid and the drop of fire. Each of your people by the moment of fire. These people I have made for myself, for my praise. I have made them to praise me. To make a name for a good one. And it's not from at least who are left in our land. Come on, tell us. We can't unite as human beings if they don't worship. And praise the Lord. Whether you are asleep, whether you are awake, whether you are aware, whether you are not, whether you are what, whether you are down, as they say, whether you are up, whether things are not working for you, whether things are working for you, you're still worshiping God. That one is a very serious testament, and it's also a very scary testament. Listen. Whether you are alive, Basi, what is true worship? True worship is to make sure that you quench your imagination and make sure that your imagination becomes aware of God every minute. Very, very important. Imagination, yeah, kila kitu ambacho unafikiri must be aware of God every moment. That is not true worship. If you realize that your imagination is not okay every time with God, it means that you're worshiping something else. But as you said, now, come on, human beings, we fall prey to some of these things many times. And
whatever the case. But let us try, we should try some to make sure that our imagination is in goal every time. Every time. Whether you are talking, whether you are a class in the bank, acknowledge God. Acknowledge God. Acknowledge God. And if you say, God did it, you know, in a second, hey, we did it. No, it's not you people who did it. The prophet you made is not you. Please, it's not you people, it's God. Hey, in my class 8, whatever, no, we did it, like I said, we did it. Because I'm a mathematics teacher, and we are the best, I don't want. No, you never did it. Please, no, God, you did it. Thank you. That is worship. Even in your workplace, you are still making your mind aware. This thing is God. In Him I move, I live, and have my being. Without Him I am nothing. Without Him I can do nothing. Acknowledge Him every time. So, how do you become, as I finish this one, how do you want to become an habitual worshiper? And best you want to be able 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 to be able. But this, but those ones of Morocco, unless they hear the beat, they can't beat. The beat, they can't beat you. Do you know where this song came from? When the music fades and all this sort of way, blessing becomes long just to beat something. God bless your heart. I'll give you more than a song. It's this simple church, this powerful church, I'm a big church. And by a man of God, called, you know, of course, he's a very powerful writer and musician. Mark Redman, he has done some of the songs you know. Songs like, bless the Lord of my soul. Mark Redman. And over there, and the church is like, if you don't worship, or you don't worship, or you don't worship, I told them somehow, without instrument, they don't worship. And the pastor said, from today, who don't have a letter, there is no instrument. Can you say, I am a blessed woman? And they sang for months. Then he can say, oh, I guess you don't have a letter. Ile ambayo hapa katikati, by the time hawa wafikiri wao hiyo ndio huko by the time wale wako nyuma wapate wale vile wakishaza wengine huko mbele. It is a church like that. No hands, what hands? And in that kisanga hiyo whatever ya hiyo hakuna music, it was market man himself. And they say there was this song, when the music fades and all is swept away, and I simply come long just to bring something that's of worth that will bless your heart. This can bring you more than soul. But the song in itself is not what you want. You know, guess something? You sat my people within you. You went things up and you say something that I'll bring you more than what? I'll bring you more than a soul. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. The rest of worship was not in the instruments, the worship was in them. Ibada kwa nani? Mnaweza kusaidia worship team sana, by the way. Mkuje kama utakuja na moto, tafadhali kuja. Acha kuja kuchukua moto wako. Leta moto. Tafadhali. At least leta moto. Kila wakati unakuja kule kuchukua moto. Kila wakati kuchukua moto. Kila wakati moto na baada ya tatu sisi ndio kwa watu moto una. Na wewe mtu wakati unakuja worship team, unasema kwa worship team you don't need us very well. Amtongozaje kwa worship team na baada ya tatu ingiani. Acha na mtu baada today. This was another problem. You are the problem. We're in the new covenant. There's no Aaron here. Are they Aaron? This one was supposed to. Let me tell something. The principles of worship in the new covenant are not the entire Christian worship leadership. Sorry. The principle of worshiping in the new covenant is not the entire Christian. We don't go and do everything on behalf of. No. We are tested. The only difference we have with you is the leadership. It's as simple as that. Otherwise, you know where we are going. With the new covenant, the curtain has been torn. You know where the Holy Spirit is. Okay, let's, if you realize that I'm taking you there, get going. You might do. What's the difference between believer? You're a new covenant believer. It's a new covenant believer. Pass you over the Holy Spirit. Ukishana wako peleke basi. Wewe mwenyewe jipeleke. Wacha kuja kusema kwamba wewe hapo tunaweza au kutufanyia hivi.
Let's start up on the feet. Hallelujah. And before we take a walk,
não me é muito a puxar aqui. Vem de uma mãe, na tia pelo outro lado, e não posso dar um desse dia, eu vou te apagar, eu vou te apagar, just come so different to you. I want to pray a tia pelo outro lado, in Jesus' name. Come on, remember. Open up your mouth, worship to Lucas, to love. Open up your mouth and pray. Tell the Lord, help me. For 2 minutes more, please just tell the Lord to help me. Tell the Lord, help me, Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord. I am praying that in the name of Jesus, your works are going to be done. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, oh God, we pray in the name of Jesus. Redeem our works in the name of Jesus. That out of our bellies shall flow rivers of living waters in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for rivers. We pray for rivers. May rivers be to flow. On Wednesday, on Thursday, on Friday, my God, Saturday, my God, on Monday, let the rivers be to flow in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Tell me, Lord. 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 Tell me, Lord.